we are going to start with the revision of the chapter 2 stories about flying. So what this chapter 2 stories about flying, there are two stories. One is of a young animal bird, which is known as seagull. Okay, the seagull who was not, you can say, ready to make a flight in the sky. So see how the, you can say, cutest character it has been portrayed. The writer has very well mentioned that seagull was not able to make a flight in the sky. Why he was not able to make a flight in the sky? Because it was afraid that his wings would not support him in the sky. Because when everyone or his brothers and sisters who were younger than him, they have flown up into the sky, high in the sky, they were also devouring the small pieces of fishes, and they were eating small pieces of fishes. They were preparing their own food. But the seagull, who was coming again and again onto the edge of the ledge. Ledge means it is a shelf. It is coming again and again onto the edge of the shelf, but it is not able to make any flight because he is not trying to, you can say, attempt to flap its wings. He used to stretch his wings, but he thought that whenever I would fly in the sky, I would make a flight. I would not be able to, my wings would never be able to support me. So he is coming again and again to the ledge, again and again trying to make a flight in the sky, but ultimately it is again receding back. Again and again it is coming back. So when his younger brothers and sisters, who were much younger than him, okay, their wings were shorter than his own, but ultimately what he was doing, they were making the flight. So his parents, they have tried each and every way in order to make him fly in the sky. They were scolding him, upbraiding him, okay, but ultimately what has happened, he was not able to make a flight in the sky. I know that these chapters, they have been read quite time long before. So you people, I know that you have forgotten many things. Okay, so this is the reason why I'm making you revise, so that you can remember them clearly. Okay, so that you will be able to attempt all types of MCQs. I'm not just summarizing it, I'm just taking it in detail, right? Okay, so finally, what is there? So, and now the parents... You can sit here. Vineet, you come forward. So, finally, for the past 24 hours, the seagull was alone on the ledge, where in a small opening it was sitting. He was all alone on the ledge. And finally, what has happened? Nobody was there to come near him. Even his brothers, sisters, mother, and father, they have left him on the ledge only. And they have gone to the nearby plateau, okay, where they were eating everything. He has seen that his father as well as mother, they were taking care of the young ones, and they were telling them how to make a flight, how to catch hold a small fish, and how to devour it, and how to cut it into pieces. And he would also, or he would often hear the cackling sound, okay. What is this cackling sound? This cackling sound is the cutting of the fish with its beaks, and then again and again, you can say, putting the beak onto the rock in order to clean it. Okay. So the sun was, you can say, ascending in the sky. He was all alone. He was trying to grab the attention of the parents as well as his brothers and sisters, so that either his father, mother, or anyone of his, you can say, younger brother or sister would come back to the ledge and would give him anything to eat. What he was doing, his head was sunken inside the, you can say, inside the neck, okay, in the wings only. And moreover, the seagull, he was, you can say, raising up one of its leg so that he could balance him over it. And at some of the times, he's dozing off and he's trying to fall down from the ledge so that anybody could come and would help him out. But his parents, they knew, okay, that this is not the right way to take care of him. And what is the right way to take care of him is to make him how to fly in the sky. Okay, so he was just looking on the nearby plateau, that anybody would come from the nearby plateau and would support him. So everyone has slept by the end of the day. not even his father, he was pruning the, you can say, feathers of his, you can say, from the white back, and they were all means taking out extra feathers. Okay, and then what happened? He has noticed that his mother, she was looking at him. Maybe she's trying to give him some food. She had a small piece of fish in her, in her beak, and she was trying to come towards him in order to give him that piece of, you can say, meat or fish. Okay, as he has not eaten for the past 24 hours. So what happened? As he was on the, you can say, brink of the ledge, or on the edge of the ledge, then what has happened? His mother has come and she has made a flight. She was moving round and round, and as soon as she has come near the young seagull who was sitting on the ledge, and what she has done, she has came near its beak to drop that piece of fish into its mouth. But what happened? The mother stopped and has thrown that piece of fish into the water. So now, because he was overpowered with this, you can say, urge of eating, as he has not eaten anything, so you know that this power of eating is stronger than anyone else. Okay, so what he did, he jumped behind that piece of fish into the sea, so that he did not know that now this will make him how to make a flight. So what happened? So as he has, you can say, jumped into the water, into the sea water, to catch hold of that piece of small fish, then what happened? He, the next moment, what happened? He felt his wings to be spread out, his wings to be spread out completely. And for a moment, he was seized with fear. Okay, so these are the type of feelings which the seagull has felt. Okay, when he made his first flight, as the name of the chapter is First Flight. How, what kind of feelings he was filled in? Okay, he was seized with terror. He was filled with terror, but ultimately it lasted only for a moment. Then afterwards, his wings who were completely spread out, and the next moment they were, you can say, flapping into the air, supporting him. So the wings had supported him. He thought that he could fall into the water, but no, it was not that. Like it was not like that, but his wings were flapping and he was, you can say, soaring in the sky. So soon there, when his parents, they have seen that their young seagull who was afraid to make a flight, now it is, you can say, flying in the sky. Then what has happened? They were moving around and round. They were circumventing around him, making a flight around him. And soon what happened? They were supporting him. Okay. So they were supporting him there, and his younger brothers and sisters, they have swooped past him. Swoop means immediately they have come along his side and pushing him, and ultimately you can say giving him strength, giving him courage. So this was the first flight that was made by the seagull. So because it was the first flight of the seagull felt tired after some time. Okay, so he has nothing to land except the green water he has in front of him. So he has landed over to on that green water, okay? And while landing on that green water, he thought that he would sink into that green water, but soon he has learned to balance its body onto the water also. So his parents, they were also, you can say, they were swimming over the top layer of the water, of the green water, and they were, they have also come there with the small pieces of dogfish that was his favorite food in order to celebrate his flight. So this is the first flight that was made by seagull. Okay, so it means that the feelings of a bird, they are being portrayed by the narrator in a very beautiful way. So he has seen how elaborately he has explained all this. So how does the young seagull come out of its fear of flying? How does the young seagull come out of its fear of flying? How it has come out of its fear of flying? Yes? Yes, Simar, how it has come out of its fear of flying? He was afraid of flying, but when he was overpowered with this urge of food and his mother has come and has dropped the food, okay, from its mouth into the water, he extended its flight into the sky, and soon his wings started supporting him. How did seagull feel when it made its first flight into the water? He was first of all afraid. He was panic stricken. He was fear stricken. But soon it was. He has overcome with this kind of fear and has started flapping its wing. And while flapping its wings, what he has done? He was moving all alone in the sky. Okay. So mainly these type of questions can be asked, right? So the next story is about the black aeroplane. Can anybody tell what this story contains? Black aeroplane? Yes, black aeroplane. Yes. Yes, this is a story. Actually, it is, you must have heard of that area, Bermuda Triangle. This story is related with that. Okay, that any aeroplane or any, you can say, ship passing through that area, it has never been recovered. Okay, now the mystery is solved. Okay, but earlier it was not like that, that the vehicles or anything that has been passing over that area, they have not been recovered. Okay, because there are some kind of special type of, you can say, areas which has been suffering from different kind of currents. Okay, different kind of currents, and because of this reason, they used to vanish from the surface of the earth only over that part of area. Okay, so this is the story about the aeroplane which has passed over that area, and finally he was saved by a mysterious aeroplane in the sky. Okay, it has been saved by a mysterious aeroplane in the sky. So let us revise. So the black aeroplane, so the pilot of the aeroplane. So what is the name of the aeroplane in which the pilot was driving? Yes, it is. Very good. The Kota DS-088. Very good. So the it was a night completely clear. The moon was up high in the sky with stars shining in the sky. And the pilot, he has made his flight from France to England. Okay. He was making his flight from France to England. And he was dreaming. He was completely excited. He was filled with, you can say, excitement to meet his family and to have his dinner breakfast, English breakfast, along with his family, because it is since a long time he has spent a time with his family, and he wanted to spend some more time with his family, and he wanted to enjoy his own type of breakfast. So he has started, he called the Paris control rooms. He found the runway as well as the pathway clear, and he has started his, you can say, he has started his flight. So when he was flying up in the sky, so he has checked the fuel tank also. He thought that the fuel tank has enough fuel so that he can fly from France to England. But suddenly what happened? So then afterwards, getting complete clear signals from the control room, he has turned his aeroplane to 12 degree west, okay, from north to south. So then afterwards, but he has hardly passed about 150 kilometers, okay. Then what has happened? He has seen strange storm clouds in front of him. The clouds, black clouds, they have covered the entire area in front of him. They were huge and they look like black mountains. He thought that he did not have enough fuel so that he could go back again to France and come back again to England. Okay, Paris. Okay, he could go back to Paris and come back to England. He didn't have that much of fuel. So he had no other choice in front of him. So suddenly what happened, he took the risk and he has driven his aeroplane into the clouds. So when he has driven the aeroplane into the clouds, then what happened? Suddenly what happened, that all the functions of the aeroplane, they stopped working altogether. Okay. So what has happened? Yes, okay, storm, everything was suddenly black. It was impossible for him to comprehend his actual position, that where he actually is. Okay, there was nothing to be seen outside. He jumped and his aeroplane, it was also shaking because of the thundering in the sky. So suddenly what happened, he looked at the compass also to check his direction. But to his surprise, what happened? His compass was running round and round again. Okay, and he was not able to find out his actual position, that where he actually is. Okay, then afterwards, all the signals, they have turned out to be dead. He was not able to make any contact with the Paris control room also. So suddenly what happened, when he was moving across the clouds, he has seen another aeroplane who was running at the same speed and at the proper, you can say, level to that of him. It was the lights of his aeroplane has gone out. He was not able to see anything outside, but through these clouds he could be able to see the other pilot who was sitting in the other aeroplane, and it was completely black in color, and who has with his hand, he has, you can say, signified him to follow him. He said that, like I, as an obedient child, had no other choice what to do. So what he did, he started following him because he had no other choice. Okay, because he knew that if he would not follow him, he would be lost in this storm of clouds. And moreover, he did not have enough fuel to go back again to Paris and refill his tank. So what happened? So ultimately, what has happened? He landed safely when he has came onto the runway, and he thought that I should contact the control room. Okay, that to thank the pilot who has helped him in this kind of strange atmosphere. But what has happened when he has gone there? When he asked the receptionist that which was that strange aeroplane in the sky. So what she has told? She has told that there was not any other aeroplane in the sky, but what actually it was? It was only his aeroplane that was in the radar that was moving. That was quite a mystery that has not been solved yet. And the pilot was surprised that which aeroplane it was who has helped him out to take him out of that storm of clouds. Right? So this is clear to you all? Okay. So I hope that these two chapters are clear. Okay, so let me take the short poem side by side in order to save time. Fire and Ice. Okay, Fire and Ice. So what this poem Fire and Ice is all about? Fire and Ice is about the two different ways of which you can say the world will come to an end. The world will definitely come to an end. Okay, it is not only with hatred. Hatred, of course, we know that it will bring an end to this world. Okay, but apart from hatred, coldness in feelings, insensitivity, okay, towards others, and moreover, you can say callousness, intolerance, indifference, rigidity in thoughts, okay, and they will also bring an end to this world. So what does fire and ice, they signify? Fire, what it signifies? It signifies, fire signifies greed, conflict, desire, fiery spirit, okay, conflict, avarice, okay, and what does ice symbolize? Insensitivity, coldness in feelings, intolerance, indifference, rigidity, as well as hatred. Okay, so fire and ice, they are symbolizing different things. So the poet is saying that the world, if not by hatred, the world will come to an end. It will definitely come to an end with the coldness in feelings. If a person will have coldness in feelings, that would definitely bring an end to this world. Okay. It will definitely bring an end to this world. Okay. So see, some say the world will end in fire and some say in ice. So the poet is saying, first of all, both these lines, they are starting with the word some. So this is an example of what? Anaphora. Anaphora. Same word starting the two lines. Okay, different lines. So this is an alliteration is in the same line. Here one line is some, second line is again with some. So this is anaphora. Okay, so the poet is saying that some people are of the opinion that this world will come to an end because of fire. And some say that the world will come to end because of ice. So I have told you what does fire and ice symbolize. Fire is hatred, greed, but ice is coldness in feelings, to be insensitive, to have unfeeling behavior towards others. It will also come to an end. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold, and those who favor fire. So this is an example of assonance. See, there is predominance of the word O. Right? Hold, those, and favor. Okay, moreover, there this is an example of enjambment. You remember now enjambment? What is enjambment? Forget. Yes, yes. When there is no punctuation mark and the same idea is carried forward. Okay, so this is enjambment. So poet is saying that what I have tasted of desire, I know that desire will definitely bring an end to this world. Strong desires. Okay, unacceptable desires will bring an end to this earth. Okay, or you can say inhuman longings. Okay, that will definitely, or unmonitored longings. Unmonitored means unchecked. They will bring an end to this world. But if it had to perish twice, but if the world will not end with, you can say fire, it will definitely end with ice. So just see that if the world has ended once, would it be able to end again? No. So it means that the poet is contradicting his own statement. This is paradox used here. Okay. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate. But poet is saying that I think that enough of hatred, insensitivity, this will definitely bring an end to this world. Okay, and to say that for destruction, ice is also great and that would suffice. It means that the poet is saying that for destruction, it is not only fire, this greed. Okay, ice will also be equally responsible to bring an end to this world. Or you can say the poet is saying that the world will also come to an end with that of ice. So you should have known that what does ice symbolize? What does ice symbolize? Coldness in relations, insensitivity, unfeeling behavior, intolerance, indifference, rigidity. And what does fire signifies? Lust, greed, avarice. Okay, fiery conflict, fiery emotions, conflict. Okay, so ice would be equally competent in order to bring an end to this world. So it does not mean that only hatred will bring an end to this world, but ice would also be equally responsible to bring an end to this world. Okay, so the poet here, he has put forward the philosophical idea. Okay, what philosophical idea? That if we let our emotions rule us, if we will let our emotions rule us, then ultimately we won't control them. Then ultimately what will happen? That they would lead to destruction. Unmonitored longings. I said unmonitored longings, uncontrolled desires. What will happen? They will bring an end to this world. Right? So this is what the poet is going to deliver through this poem. So it means that the poet, who is the poet of this poem? Robert Frost, right. Robert Frost, who has a profound idea. What is the meaning of profound? Deep. Deep. Deep idea that the world would end either in one of the two ways. Either the hatred will bring the end to this world, but if somehow the world would escape its death because of not of fire, it would definitely be the coldness in emotion, insensitivity towards others, or you can say indifference, that will bring an end to this world and the world will come to an end. So being a wise human being, we have to be sensitive towards the feelings, towards the desires of others, towards the requirements as well as you can say expectations of others. But moreover, hatred will also, what will bring? It will bring. So we should leave apart hatred, indifferences. Okay, and try to come together, try to join together so that we can save our this earth. Right? So I hope that now it is clear. All the three topics that I have discussed with you, I think they are revised. If you have any doubt, now you can raise up your hands.